Yeah, hello. Is it audible? Can anyone please chat? Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, hi. Audible, right?
Yeah, it is audible.
Okay, right. Thank you. Okay, so let's start waiting. First of all, I would like to say thank you so much for joining this online class, UI with full stack. Okay. Thing is, what is UI? UI with full stack is a course, right? So what exactly UI? What do you mean by UI? So UI means user interface, right? So user interface, who is the user? We are all the users. Interface means that's a mediator between the you and the product. Okay, see, every product or every software or every website, there is a mediator. You know what? The front end, the visual design, what you can see, that's called the UI. Okay, so suppose for any company, they have a product or they have something, some services they want to serve to other people, right? All over the world. So how they can serve you? Because how can you interact with that product or the website or the services? Is they will make a website. Okay, generally UI means there are three types of UIs, like a desktop UI, website UI, and mobile apps UI. Okay, so desktop UI means the software which can install in your system or laptop, the installable, like any audio player or video player or any games that you install in your system, that's a desktop UI or the computer UI. Another thing is what? The mobile apps. You install the app in your mobile and you can just start seeing the or start interacting with the products, right? That's a mobile app. But in this session or in this tutorial, what we're going to see is we're not going to discuss about the desktop applications. We're not going to discuss about the mobile apps. We are purely discussing about the websites. So how you develop a website and what technologies involve and what is our learning plan, we're going to see now. Okay, but before I talk about this, I wanted to tell you why we want websites. What is exactly the importance of websites? Let me just switch on my this. Yeah. Okay. So now tell me, why actually we want a website? Because we are living in a such a virtual world and we are tightly coupled with the technology, right? So whatever the information we want now, we just go to online, we just go to the Google and we just search about it, right? So anything you want to learn, anything you want to know, any service you want, you just search online, right? So let's take an example. The best example is, I can say, any examples? So a person who has born from the born to the death, whatever activity he is doing in the web. Correct? See, what's the example I tell you? See, one person, one small boy has born. Okay, one small kid has born, right? So for that kid, I want to propose a name, right? So previously, have you proposed a name? You just ask your relatives or you ask your family, friends or someone to just suggest a name, right? But now what happened? We just search online. So could you please suggest me some baby name starts with some character, right? And recently, one of my friend has shared his question in the Facebook. Could you please suggest a baby name for my kid? Okay, fine. After that, the kid is slowly growing. And we want to purchase him some toys or clothes, okay, all these things. So where you purchase? We purchase online. And after that, the kid has to go for a education. So education means we have to search for a school, right? So where are we going to search? Again online? Again the website? Okay. So kid has joined. Again, we have to look for the uniform, the stationery, everything online. And the kid is just slowly growing again and he won a admission to the college again online. again, what you call the entrance exam online, counseling online, joining online, and everything. And after that, after completion of graduation, the person want to join a company. So he just search a job online. Okay. And you know what? If this person want to get a marriage and he want to search a boy or girl, he just search online. Okay. There are a lot of matrimony websites are available. And thank God, only searching is happening, but marriages are not happening online. Because recently I saw one Facebook video where marriage is happening online. What is that? You know, the group of people, like the girl's family is there in India and the boy's family is there in USA, and they are having a video call. Okay. So what happened? One pandit, or what we call this Purohit, and that person is here and also that side in USA also. So that person is telling, okay, do puja to this laptop and you can tie up. Thank God he has not tied up to the laptop. Okay, so that much interaction is happen. I mean, that much involvement is happen with the technology. So I can say for anything, for every service, for every request, whatever you want, we just search online and we want a website. Okay, so now we have a conclusion that yes, we need a website. Okay. And also don't think like, okay, website means it's not only for software industry. Okay, it can be for any field, because we are all from different backgrounds. Some people are from mechanical, some people from electronics, some people from civils, like different categories, right? MBA or medical or something. So everybody want a website, right? So let's see, if one person having a small business, right? Now what happened, he want to grow his business, he want to make a website. So that business belongs to anything, any category, right? Or else let's take a mechanical industry. So in mechanical, they are producing some new products. So they want to approach the people who are all over the world. They want to attract the customers, right? So they wanted to have a website. Okay, so through the website, they'll give a URL and they'll post it online and they'll do a SEO to attract the people all over the world. So not only medical or mechanical, and even the best example is civil engineering. So these people, what they're doing is, earlier they just go to the site and show him like, so what type of development is happening in their area. So now what happened? The complete real estate, you know, what is the infrastructure, everything is, they just make a website or app and they just come to the customer and they're just showing in a tab that what is development is going to happen over there. So that much, you know, involvement is happening in the technology side. Okay. So what we understood here is we want a website for anything. Okay. And it can be not the software industry. It can be anything. It can be any field. We wanted a website. Okay. And now, but what type of website we want? So what type of website we want? What type of website means? Okay. I just tell you one simple example. People don't like a normal website like Wikipedia. Okay. I'll give you two options. Wikipedia and the Facebook. Which one you like? Wikipedia or Facebook? Hello? Anybody
obviously
there?
Obviously Facebook.
Obviously Facebook, right?
Yes.
Okay. Because, oh, what's the reason behind? Because, yeah, tell me.
Because we have so many user interaction.
Yes, that's correct. Yes. See, Wikipedia doesn't have much. You're just having images and some text. That's very, very normal, right? But in Facebook, we have a lot of interaction, and we even don't know ourselves that we are spending a lot of time out there. After spending some hour with 1 hour time without knowing ourselves, and once after that we realize that we just stuck up with one website, you know, that's called user interface. I call it as user interaction. So nowadays how the websites are designing is they have to attract the people, they have to make the people busy with the website, busy with the services. That's what we want. So people don't like a normal website. People only like the rich and the interaction website, which we can attract the people towards your service. So your service, you want to approach the people, you have to attract the people to your service, right? So then only your business will grow. So for that reason, to make such rich websites, we want UI developer. So my dear upcoming UI developers, so we wanted to make such type of website, so rich look. Okay, people don't like a normal look and feel. And even, you know, the typical Indian mentality is what? People, by seeing the person attire only, they'll decide. The person is having a very, what you call, a normal dress and all, people don't care, man. I'm the person who is having the look by seeing the cutout matters, right? By seeing the cutout only, people understand, oh, this may be something great, right? And the people who talk, what you call, the perfect English, we call it as he is having more knowledge. That's a front-end part, okay? People don't know what is inside. Same thing in a website also. So if you have any product, if you have any software, for that, if you are not able to build a proper UI, the user interaction, maybe product will fail. Because so how much backend technology you use and how much algorithm you write in the backend, but people only care the UI. So for every field, for every environment, for every platform, we need a website and we must need a UI developer. And you know what? There are a lot of jobs available for UI developer, but only one condition, that who learn the proper hands-on experience on the UI. Okay, that's what we're gonna do in this class. Okay, so now, okay, so we understand the UI. So for UI, what technologies are there? Sir, what are the technologies I have to learn? There are many technologies you have to learn. Okay, just talk about website architecture. Yeah, I just come to this slide later. Okay, what technologies for this UI? There are many technologies involved for the UI, especially HTML, CSS and all. Okay, before discussing about technologies, the technology is actually divided into some categories, like client side some technologies, server side some technologies, and database some technologies like that. Okay, so first, okay, let's see the architecture only. Website architecture. Okay, so for every website, we have majorly three parts, or we call three layers. Client side, server side, and database. You take any website, it's like a Facebook, Amazon, whatever, is having three parts: client, server, and database. But just for 2 minutes, I just explain how the conversation happened between all these three. Okay, assume you all have a Facebook account, right? You always log into the Facebook, right? Sometimes at least. So now for Facebook, first you, what you do, you just open a facebook.com and you just click on a sign up, right? So once you click on a sign up, you get the page for the sign ups. You have to enter your name, your age and your gender and some information you have to enter, and click on sign up. So as soon as you click on the sign up, the page, what you can see, is called as the client. Okay. And then as soon as you click on the sign up, the whole data will be sending to the Facebook server. So that is behind the scenes. We can't able to see that. Only your browser knows where exactly the server, and it just send it because based on the URL. Okay. So as soon as you click on the sign up, the whole data sent to the Facebook server. So Facebook server start processing your details. Is that correct or not? It does just supply some validations. It also check, is that hacking or is that normal? It's not a robo or user. So some sort of validation will happen. And after that, the same data will be stored in something called database for permanent registration, because next time when you log in, it has to show the details, right? So it stored data in a database. Okay, fine. Next time when you click on the login button on the client, and you enter the username and password and click on login. So as soon as you click on login, you get the whole page, right? You get the your photo, your notification, your chat information. So everything you're gonna get on the page. So how this happen? You know, behind the scenes, as soon as you click on the login, you got a page. But how this happens is, this whole structure is there behind. It means, as soon as you click on the login, the whole details sent to the server. And this server verifies your details and already registered details will match. Is that matching happen? If any data available for any the basic data at least, which is available for this particular account, they just grab the data from the database and they prepare a proper page from the server and that will be sent back to the user so that you can see the page. That's how every application, every website which is having a login system will works like that. Okay, so now for client side and server side and database, what are the technologies we have to learn? See, actually there are two things are there you have to clarify. What is that is UI technologies is there, full stack is there. What is UI? What is full stack? UI technology means the person who is involved in the complete development of only the client side thing, okay, only the design part, we call him as UI developer. Okay, and the person who is called as full stack developer is UI with full stack is not only responsible for the client side, he's also responsible for the server as well as database. So a person can do a client side technology involved with server, involved with database. So complete application development solution, the person who can given, that person we call it as full stack developer. Because initial days we only choose UI developer separately and server side developer separately and database developer separately. But now technologies has a lot of change happened in the technology and people looking for the person who can do all the things. That's what full stack. Okay. So what technologies we have to learn for the client side is HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, Ajax, and Bootstrap, and some frameworks like React or Angular or Vue.js. So these are all the technologies for client side. For server side, we have a lot of technologies like Java, .NET, PHP and all. But as part of the UI, in this course, we have a server side is Node.js and Express.js. And database, we can choose any of the database like MySQL or SQL Server or MongoDB or Firebase. A lot of options you have. Okay, so by clubbing all the technologies together, we call them as UI with full stack. Okay, so in this course, what we're going to do is we're going to learn all these technologies in a proper manner. Okay, so up to here, any questions, guys? Hello, please interact with me.
Nothing.
Can I go ahead?
No, sir.
Yeah, okay, yeah, so thank you. Some people chatting once again. Oh, okay, okay. People are doing chatting. Okay, fine. So now we understand, okay, what technologies involve. And also now we'll understand what is a plan. Because before you're going to start with, you should know the plan. Because I tell you one simple example. You're in one place. From this place to, you want to go to some other place around some 500 kilometers. You want to travel. So you want to travel from this place to that place, you just search, okay, what are all the places you have to halt and where you have to take a rest and how you go there and how much time you reach. So you should know the complete information, then only you can go there, right? Otherwise, you may stuck in between. The same concept will be applied here because the course duration is 45 to 50 days into 2 hours. It will be around 100 hours, okay, 90 to 100 hours. So in this, what technologies we learn and how we learn and what websites we develop, we just have a look. Okay, now let me open Notepad plus. Yeah, here. So what technologies we just learn is we're gonna learn is HTML and HTML5. Okay, CSS and as well as CSS3, and we also learn the JavaScript. And JavaScript with I'm gonna teach ES6 or ES7, and we're gonna learn Bootstrap, and we're gonna learn jQuery, and we learn Ajax, and we learn Node.js, Express.js, and MongoDB, and we learn React.js, and we also learn some unit testing. Like there are some frameworks out there like Mocha and chai, and also one framework is there, and finally a project. Many projects are there, but I'm just highlighting this project. So project using MERN. So MERN means MongoDB, ExpressJS, React, and Node. Okay, I just come to this one. So first we just see HTML, because every website development has to start with HTML, because HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Okay, so this is the basic technology you have to learn for every website development. Okay, because that's a base. Generally, you want to build a building, right? So what we're going to start? We're going to start with the basement, and we're going to start with the structure, the pillars, slabs, and then we start with the walls and interiors and all, right? Same like that for every website, we need to make a structure. So that structure can be made with HTML. And we have the CSS. The CSS stands for the cascading style sheet. It means you have to apply some styles, colors, animations. So a lot of interaction UI can be made with the CSS. Okay, along with that, JavaScript. You want to provide some dynamic functionality for your website, you have to go for the JavaScript. In this, we're gonna learn the ES6 and 7, the new advanced JavaScript we're gonna learn. And then Bootstrap. So this is actually I called as a library of HTML and CSS. With this, we can develop any website in an easy manner. You can even develop with these two. We can also develop with the Bootstrap. Simple example, sir, if you can develop a website with HTML and CSS, then why we go for a Bootstrap? Simple thing. You want to go travel, you can go with the bicycle, you can even go with the bike, you can even go with the car, right? Which is more comfortable is car, right? Same like that, assume if you are developing any website best only using HTML and CSS, it's just like a bicycle. Okay, yes, with that bicycle also you can reach, but what you may strain and it may take a lot of time. Okay, but if you start with a Bootstrap, it's like a bike, is a comfortable bike or car. Okay, so with that we can reach in a less time and more comfortable. That's what the difference. Okay, fine. And then jQuery. So jQuery is a library of JavaScript, because the next layer of JavaScript is jQuery. It means again HTML and CSS to simplify, we have a Bootstrap. To simplify this JavaScript coding, we have a jQuery and Ajax. And then we have something called Node.js and Express.js. So these two are the server-side scripting we're going to use for server-side development. We're going to use these two. And MongoDB, or I'm going to teach you one more called MySQL. So these two for database, and React.js. So React.js is a, I call as library, because there are many, many frameworks are there like Angular or Vue. So this also comes under the same category, but it's called as library. I don't consider this, what you call this, jargons or technical terms. Don't worry at this time, because we're going to learn each and everything in detail. So this React.js is for, again, client side only, because just mixing all these technologies in a proper manner we can do with React.js. It's a complete application development solution for the client side. We're going to use this, and we're going to do unit testing and then one application. So this is the plan of our UI technology with full stack. Okay, fine. But in this, something you have to understand. What is that is, sir, everybody will teach the UI technology in their own way, because multiple ways we can learn, right? But what is the way, what is a proper way of learning something is, I tell you. And what are we are going to learn in this class, also I tell you. Thing is, we're gonna start with first HTML, okay? So how we start with HTML? Actually, what is there in HTML? You know what? In HTML, we have almost 50 plus tags are there. So tags like something called HTML, CSS, some language it is. Okay. So in HTML, we have 50 plus tags. So how are we learning the tags? It's not like simply what you call, we can just learn what is a tag and not like a notes writing or something. We are going to develop some application with the tags. So we just see first, what is the tag? What is the usage of the tag? And what is the real example of the tag? And like that, we just learn. And also, I don't like the people to learn all the tasks together, like one by one in this way. I just divided the entire HTML course like three parts. What is that is? We are not going to learn all the 50 tags together. First, we just learn 10 tags. Only the first 10 tags we just learn. Okay, so how we learn? What is a tag? How to use the tag? And what is the real example of the tag? And after that, first we learn the 10 tags. By clubbing all the 10 tags, we're going to develop one small website. Yes, we can develop using the first 10 tags also, we can develop a website, right? So we develop a website just by using only the 10 tags. Done. After that, we learn the next 10 tags or 15 tags. We just club all together. We make a website. And after that, the remaining HTML 5 tags we learn and the same way. And by clubbing all together, we develop a website. So what I'm saying is only in the HTML course, we're going to develop three websites. So if you develop like this, so you just get a closer understanding of actually where we gonna use the HTML concepts. And after that, we're gonna start with CSS. In CSS, we have a lot of properties and a lot of styles and all this. So we just learn one by one, and then by clubbing all together, we just develop some examples, and also we just develop some websites. Okay, so that's the plan. And finally, JavaScript, we also develop a lot of applications, and Bootstrap, we develop two websites, and jQuery, we have a lot of applications and plugins, Ajax, we have examples, and Node.js, Express.js, MongoDB, React. So like that, in React also, we have a lot of examples. So we just learn all the things in the proper hands-on experience in a, what you call hands-on experience. And then by clubbing all the technologies, we're going to develop finally one project. Okay. So it's like, okay, till now what we understand, we just see, okay, how we are going to learn and what type of things we can do. It is like a simple example. One salesman will come to your home, right? So he want to sell something. He just keep that product behind. He just keep hold his hands back. And he'll keep the product backside and he'll show you like, sir, this product is like this, like this, like this. But what is your next question? Okay, I understand that. What is your product? You explain, but show me the product first, right? Okay, so be ready to see the product. Okay, so let's see what type of example we're going to develop, because I have already pre-planned. So I show you them. Let me go to... I'll just show you some 4PM batch. Okay, HTML. See, I have HTML, CSS, Bootstrap, jQuery, and all. Let me start with HTML. Yeah, in HTML, this is our course content of HTML. In this, we start with headings, paragraphs, div tags, span tag, images, text formatting, like many tags are there. You wanted to know them. I show you. HTML headings. This is just HTML headings. One second, someone is making some noise. Mute all. Yes. Okay, fine. No, fine. So I'm also mute. No, right? Okay, fine. See, this is HTML headings. Yeah, you feel like, sir, is that the first example? Don't worry. Next example is 1 minute. Second is, okay, paragraphs. We discuss what is paragraph and little bit of styles. And then div tag. Yes. So how to design the page like this. And then span tag, like individual characters. And then we just learned some text formatting, the direct text, inserted, strikeout, mark, and all. Unordered list. This is unordered list. And this is ordered list. And this is various images. And image from Google. And tables, table with call span, row span, and custom table, and HTML links. So normal links and images a link, and this download bookmark, and HTML entities, and then iframes. Okay, how to display YouTube video here. So like that. So these are the first part of because I told HTML we have three parts. So first part is these tags. Okay, so not only just learning these tags, by clubbing all these tags, we're going to develop a website. Okay, I just show you the website first by learning this tags. The website is here only. The website is food website. Yes, this is the first website we're going to do in the first 3 days of HTML class. This website, okay. The third day we're going to develop this. It's very simple website. Some of my posts. Welcome to the It's actually welcome. Welcome to Yummy Food World. You have some images and burgers collection and fire and ice. Eat healthy and stay healthy. Do Google Eat Noodle. Enjoy the results and the copyright. Okay. So we learn images, we learn headings, we learn paragraphs, we learn tables. We just club all together and we just make a website. And in this process, we also learn a little bit of CSS. Okay. This is the first website. And then what? The next part of HTML. The next part of HTML is the HTML forms. So we're going to start with the form elements, like what are all the form, different type of form elements and the form input types. There are various types of inputs and then form input attribute. There are some special attributes. And after learning all these tags about forms, we develop the second website is this one. This is the second website of HTML, online job application form. Which having some categories like personal information and education details, work experience and other details and two buttons. So we're going to do the live coding here. No copy paste. Okay. We do from the scratch. Okay. There's a second website and third one. 1 minute. Let me drag it to here. Okay. Fine. So the third one company website, this one. So here it is involved HTML 5 tags like header tag, navbar, sidebar, and all this. This is the third website of just HTML. Okay, you just not even start the CSS. So you click on CSS, jQuery, Node.js, MongoDB, Ajax, and the footer like this, and HTML. Okay, this is the website. So we develop 1, 2, and 3. So three websites we can develop only using the HTML course content. So once you develop all these three, HTML is finished. Okay, then we're going to start with the CSS. Okay, let's have a look about the CSS. In CSS, okay, these are the concepts of CSS. Like many things are there, like colors, backgrounds, borders, margin, padding, text formatting, tables, a lot of things. I show you some examples, not all examples because we don't have that much time to understand all the examples. I show you some highlights like a vertical navigation bar. Yes, so how we develop a vertical navigation bar, some fancy icons, and horizontal navigation bar. Yes, this is one horizontal navigation bar with some fixed top. Okay, and drop down. Yes, you have a drop down. And the tooltip drop down navbar. So we have a navbar with the drop down and HTML for the CSS forms. Yeah, this is one CSS form. Okay, fine. And image gallery, you have a image gallery. So like this, and we also do some sort of animations. These are very basic animations. This is CSS concept, and we also see some transformations. Yeah, this is one transformation like zoom effect, and this is some animation, some transformation, this one, and this is one transformation, and this one, and this one, and this one. This is some 3D transformation here, and then we'll see some animations also, like the very first animation we'll discuss is this. This is one animation. And animation 2, this is one animation. Okay, these are all CSS concepts. And then animation 3, this is an animation. One cycle is just moving around. And animation 4, this is, this is also one animation. Okay, so we have to do this type of things. Okay, so after learning all these, they're all just concepts, okay, not a website. After learning all the concepts, we're going to develop multiple websites. So first website I show you, that is this one, some gadgets website. Yeah, this is a website of CSS, UiBrains Technologies, and it's having the 5 pages, home page, some laptops, mobiles, and tablet news. And see, we have learned the zoom effects, and we're going to apply in the website here, and this one, and this one, and the footer. Okay, and news, we have a news page and various cards here, and the gallery page, you have the gallery with some animation and a zoom effect for each gallery image. Okay, and then about us page, about us, who are we, what we develop, our clients and the client images, contact us, and you have a small contact page like this. This is one website of CSS and HTML, no JavaScript and no Bootstrap involved here. Okay, so after that, one more website I plan, that is this one, online resume. So about yourself, experience, education, skills, interest, certifications, with some transition like that. Okay, this is second website. Actually, I feel these websites are a bit older. I also made some new websites. I show you them. One is UiBrains Financial. Yeah, this one, because generally nowadays people like only this type of website because people are looking for the rich UI. Okay, I also tell you how can you make this type of landing page with the CSS. Okay, and so what do we do, some cards, normal CSS and HTML, no Bootstrap, and amazing place for investment, our services, and this one, and one contact form, and copyright. Okay, this page, I am also building one more page, that is it's not completely done. Yeah, this one, food delivery stores, news, and sign up, and this one. Okay, it's not completely done, just only landing page. Okay, this one. So this is about only CSS. So we just see only HTML and CSS. Now let's see the JavaScript. Okay, so JavaScript mostly not complete website development, it's just for dynamic thing. So JavaScript means the complete programming concepts. So we're gonna start with the basic programming concepts, and then we apply to the website. That's the place where the DOM manipulation concepts. Okay, here what type of example I show is DOM events, three, some examples I show you. Okay, this is something like dynamic. You click on all employees, you get some all employees, 449, male employees and female employees. And you can even have a search. You can just start with A. See all the people who are all start with A. If I say AL, 8, ALL, 2 people, like that. Okay, this is something dynamic. And a lot of things are there. We also have a form validation. Click on register, you get some form validation with JavaScript. And we have a small number app, that is you just type whatever the number you have, it just type it, it just give you in a string representation, something dynamic. And yeah, they are just basic example. Actual example is this one, type in tester app. Okay, this one. So what is this type in tester app is, whatever the text you have to type it. So as soon as you start typing, your timer starts, and you have various lessons to load. Okay, let me start with you. See, you got some what do you call, sounder, right? So thanks for learning UI technology. You also play some audio file. Okay, you can just research, and you can just load various lessons, and you can try. Okay, this is something dynamic of JavaScript. I mean, you have a lot of things. One calculator app, this one, and you have to enter some number. I'll just show you. 100 and 2 equal to this one. So minus slash star. Okay, like this. Clear. Less. Okay, this one simple calculator app using JavaScript. And promises, callbacks, they're all just programming concepts. And there is something called dependent select box. Yeah, this is very important for interview. So you just see, second one is nothing. As soon as you select Maruti Suzuki, you get some various other models. If you click on Nexa, only Nexa models. If you select some Tata Motors, you got data model. This one dependency select box you can do with the JavaScript. And there is something called digital watch. See the Indian time, US time, and China time. So Indian time is 5:57. Oh, already 1 hour. Okay. And US time is this, and China time is this. See, for them evening, for us in the morning. Okay, this is something dynamic thing you can do with JavaScript, and this front end is bootstrap. A lot of examples are there, these many. Fine, and there's something called counter also. Well, this counter, yeah, you can just click on the start, it just start doing some incrementation, and also see the color is changing. Okay, so as soon as it reaches 100, so yes, that's it. This is one JavaScript example. Okay, so this is about JavaScript course content, but I have not showed all the programs, only the UI part I showed. Okay, and then we're gonna start with something called Bootstrap. So in Bootstrap also we have a lot of concepts. So this is the course content of Bootstrap. So we have typography, alignments, plots, position, backgrounds, buttons. See some interesting buttons. Okay, so large button, block level button, drop down. Okay, and navbars. We have a lot of navbars, and we have responsive navbars. This is Bootstrap concepts. Okay, and we have list groups and forms. We have some fancy login forms like this. This is Bootstrap, and some input groups. This is the input groups, and alerts and progress. These are some alert boxes, and some progress bars and tables. And you have cards. Yeah, some cards. So how we develop this type of cards? This type of card. This is Bootstrap. And you have a how to develop a carousel. So these are simple carousel, simple slider with controls, indicators, and some captions, crossfade, and some custom slider with some custom animations. Okay, this one, and the collapse model. Yeah, this model actually is very, very important for every website, because you can click on register, you get some sort of model. Okay, this one, this is Bootstrap concept. So we just learn everything from the scratch, okay? And also, not only learning these concepts, we just made a website, okay? Let's see the website. One is admin dashboard index. Yeah, this is one admin dashboard website we're going to learn in this class. It is like your project website. So what are the projects involved here, and how many people are working on it, and what tasks are there? It's like a complete project dashboard. So here we have a lot of pages. Add task, you have a one model. See, we learn the model, we're gonna apply here. Okay, and add category, some chart. 1 second, your laptop, my charger. Oh, thank you so much. Let me on. Yeah, it's charging now. Okay, thank you. Okay, this is category, add employee. Okay, so click on task page. You have a task page. You can have a search and the categories and the employees. Okay, and also one more thing, we have a direct link here. You click on the view details of task, it goes to the task page like this. Okay, and you can even check for this categories, it goes for categories page like that. And finally, employees also. You can just check all the links like this. And I have login, and this is my profile like this. And you can change the password. Back to dashboard, and you can do some settings. Back to dashboard and click on logout. There's a login page. Actually, confirm password is not required here. Login. Yes, this is the page. This is the first page. I mean, the first website of Bootstrap, and the second website of Bootstrap we're going to develop is something called one corporate website, one company website. This one. Yeah, UiTechnologies technologies home base, having just 4 pages, one slider, and best faculty, best coding skills, and best course material, and what you're gonna learn UI with main stack. And this is some light box. This is actually a jQuery plugin, and complete Java course, AngularJS, Bootstrap, and this is one contact model, and about page. This is about page, meet the trainers. You have a transformation from CSS, and the courses. So what courses we're gonna offer, okay, course details and the price details, some basic information and the contact us, and contact information and the contact us. Okay, and this is the second website, and even I'm planning some more websites on Bootstrap. I just tell you while we are starting with the course. Okay, as of now these two I have, and that's about Bootstrap. And where we shop HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and Bootstrap is over. Now start with jQuery. Okay, jQuery, a lot of things are there. I show you some. Mostly we use jQuery for plugins and form validation and Ajax. Okay. So I show you some sort of plugins. What we're going to do in the class is, one is Magnify plugin. You know, for Flipkart or Amazon, we just zoom on the product, right? Yeah, that's a Magnify plugin. It looks like this. So you have a gallery. As soon as you keep a cursor here, see, so you can just zoom like this. Okay. So this is the magnification plugin we're going to apply with the Bootstrap. Okay. And then, yeah, it works for all the images. This one, this one, this one, like this. What curry it is? I don't know. Next, count to plugin. I think you might have seen this type of counter in your website, and even I have one counter in my UiBrains. Yeah, see, after some time, age will stop, right? Okay, so some timer and start number and final number, you can just increment like this. So mostly every website is having this type of thing. This is a jQuery plugin. And like that, we have a lot of plugins. I show you them. And one more type tester app is there here with a complete jQuery and Bootstrap. This is one more sort of type tester app. So as soon as you start typing some different type of information, and your milliseconds and seconds starts here. Okay. And a lot of things. I show you some, like, jQuery validation. This is very, very important. Form validation. So how you validate the form? We also see the form validation somewhere. It's gone somewhere. A lot of examples. Yeah. So this is one jQuery form validation, because real time they're going to use not normal JavaScript form validation. People use the jQuery form validation because this is more efficient and more scalable. So let's see. This is, you have a form. You click on register. So you got something like this. So please provide the first name. If I enter one character, please enter at least three letters. V. He got success automatically. Yes, this is one jQuery form validation, because real time they're going to use only this. So we even learn how to make this. And then jQuery dependent select bus, we also seen this in the JavaScript also, and same thing we have with jQuery also. And this is one more plugin, animation on scroll. So I think you might have seen some website, as soon as you scroll, some animation you're gonna apply, right? This is what that. So you have this one, second one with some animation. This is some animation. So as soon as you scroll down, you're gonna get some sort of animation, and you're scrolling back, just keep going as per its animation, right? Yeah, this is one jQuery animate on scroll plugin. We have to use all these plugins together, then you can make an awesome website. Okay, that's what a UI developer has to do. Next, one 3D slider we have, some interesting one. You can just apply for any of your websites. See, some 3D slider. Okay, it's actually automated. We don't need to click on anything. You just rotate its own time. We can even change the time also. Okay, this is one 3D slider of jQuery. And jQuery lightbox, one lightbox is there. This is one lightbox plugin. It means like this. It shows some what image you wanted, and you can even just click on them. You can even share it, download, and maximize, minimize. This is one plugin, lightbox plugin. It's like complex plugin. We're gonna see in the class. And like that, Ajax. I show you one Ajax example. So see, this data is actually coming from the server. Without refreshing the page, you may get some data from the server. Okay, this is Ajax example. You have many examples, but I just show him one. Okay, so it's just keep loading infinite times. Okay, now that's about jQuery and Ajax. And Node.js, we have a lot of examples, like Node.js, Express.js, and MongoDB. And we also develop an application on Node Express and MongoDB. And we're gonna start with React.js. in that we have a lot of examples, but I can't show you all these examples because I have to start with the server and database. So while the course is going to happen, I'll show you. Okay. So this is our course content. Okay. Now let me come back, and now we'll have questions. Can you please ask me some questions, please?
Yeah, are we going to learn complete React.js on this course?
Complete React.js means except React hooks we learn, because I'm planning. I think I can add React hooks also in the last, but as of now React hooks are not there. But except React hooks, everything we're gonna learn.
May I know what about Redux or something? ASX.
Redux.
Yeah.
The state management. Yes, we're gonna learn.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, are we going to learn RESTful applications?
RESTful, yes, we have. Okay. Actually, that concept will come in a Node.js.
Okay.
Node.js, so how to develop the REST API, we do it. And also from the React.js, how can we connect with a RESTful API, and how can you get the data, how can you update data, the complete code operation we can do with RESTful API, okay, with React and Node.
Okay, so we are going to complete this course within 45 to 60 days. Am I right?
Yes.
So we have any holidays like Sundays?
Holiday means, yeah, only Sunday is a holiday.
Only Sunday. Okay,
yeah, Sunday. Perfect. Sunday, that's so Indian this, time, because okay. US time, maybe it is Monday, yeah, or Saturday.
So is this timings will change in mid of the session?
No change.
No, nothing.
Right. 5 to 7 fix.
Okay, perfect.
Because is that not comfortable for you?
No, this is the comfortable. If something happens in...
No, nothing is going to happen. As before starting the course only, we'll fix it, and that's final.
So,
yeah. Okay. Any other questions? Anybody, please? Yeah, please, yeah. You can ask. Yeah.
Hello, sir. Yeah, I think that's... I like the syllabus and everything pretty much because...
Okay,
like
thank you. Thank you.
HTML and CSS is not like a big issue, but we are building like a website, right? That is, yes, which is good. Yeah. So, yeah, I really like it. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Any questions?
So you're covering everything, but why are you not covering like a PHP or some language? Because it makes the full-fledged full stack developer, right?
PHP.
Yeah. Like any
PHP, some I understood. Yeah. But PHP again is a long story, because if you add that, it'll go again more than almost another 10-15 days you have to add extra. So I was just really concentrating on the, yeah.
Currently in US, like people are asking for full stack having experience on PHP, not even Java.
Okay, but PHP, yeah, I can just say, because I'm not good at PHP, because I can't talk about it. So you can just go refer any other course of PHP, because in this class, server side means Node and Express, because that's JavaScript content. Because if you know the JavaScript client side, the same JavaScript you can use as server side, and even database also, the most of the things with the JavaScript coding only. So UI with full stack is with Node.js. Better if you want to learn extra PHP, please, you can learn any other place, because a lot of tutorials are there for PHP, because we are not learning PHP.
So are you adding AngularJS also,
sorry, we are not adding AngularJS, but I have a plan of adding a little bit of Angular, because AngularJS is outdated. Almost all the companies are migrate to the Angular. So AngularJS is not covering. Let me try here. If any spare time is there, we're gonna see the Angular 8 or 9 here. At least some one or two applications we're gonna develop with Angular 8, because mine is main focus on React. Okay. If any time is there, definitely we're gonna see the Angular 8 or 9.
Yeah, Naveen, we have seen a lot of opportunities for React.js.
Yeah.
Angular is outdated.
Sorry?
Actually,
AngularJS is outdated.
Yes, yes.
Like, although we cannot cover a lot in Angular 8, you can guide us maybe like few days how to do some kind of simple project, and that will help for us. And I'm okay with the content, course of content.
Yes, seriously. I just talk about Angular 8 and how can you do the start with the projects, because it's not like simply learning the concept. You have to develop something, because then only you can understand how really the technology is going to be used. So that's my plan. So I just start covering of it. Because as of now, I don't have any application to show you. But meanwhile, I'll do it. No problem. Any questions?
So what happens, sir? In any case, like a class, anybody missed class, you will provide recording too, right, sir?
Yes. I'm recording, and I'll share the recording of the video daily. And it'll be last for 1 year. You can just reuse them for 1 year. And I just gonna show you the course highlights. So meanwhile, I'm gonna ask some questions. I'll tell you the course highlights after this. Yeah, any questions? No? Okay, fine. I'll ask the questions in the last again. First, let me cover what is the course highlights. Okay, or course highlights. Okay, what course highlights here is? First thing, it's a complete hands-on experience. Complete hands-on experience. It means it's not just only learning the subject. We have to know where we can use the subject, because that's what industry wants. Okay? Because in earlier days, what happened, people just ask the questions and you have to answer the question with your own definitions, and then people will take it. But now what happened, you know, if you are a fresher or experienced or whatever, they will give you one task. It's like they'll give you one page or website, and you have, they'll give the complete software setup, everything with you, and you have to develop that particular page with the given technology. So that's what the coding test. So if you want to if you finish the coding test, then only you can go for the next level of the face-to-face, because people don't call directly for face-to-face. And recently what I get to know that is, if you want to apply for any job on UiTechnologies, it's very simple. They are not even calling a candidate to the company. What they're doing is, they just give you one link. They just share with your email ID one link, and in that link, they'll be giving like one image. So we have to develop a website like this, and this is what our scenario. So please make a website and share me the source code with the same email. So that they'll verify that. And is that done in a given time, like they'll give you like 2 or 3 days. If you have done this, you search anywhere. You search in Google, you ask your friend, you make your friend to do it, whatever you do, but finish it within given timeline and send them. So as soon as you send the task, they'll verify, and then they'll just propose for the next level called face to face. Okay, so coding is must and should. Okay, that's what I'm gonna highlight here. And that's a hands-on experience. And also, people ask for notes. I have a notes. Okay, notes will be shared. I show you the notes in a moment. And I show you the notes also now first. Notes means I have prepared one PDF file, so I share that. Notes. Yeah, this one. This is our course PDF file, some 383 pages. So here I explain, it's loading. Not responding. Yeah. See, what is UI development and what is server? This we'll discuss tomorrow. What is the project development and all? So it's a complete notes with how to install the software to the complete course content. It's not loading properly. Yeah, with the source code also it is there. See the buttons and all, we have seen the bootstrap, right? The same thing. Okay, this is the notes. And I'm going to share this notes as soon as you paid. And hands-on experience and this one, and code. Yeah, code is most important, because why I'm going to share the code is, on daily basis I'm going to share. Why? Because maybe, so while seeing the video or the recording, you can start doing by yourself, but maybe you commit a mistake and then maybe syntax errors will come, right? So you may keep doing it and it's a waste of time. So I just share the code You just see the code wherever you stuck, and with that you can just practice yourself. So code will be shared on daily basis. Okay, daily. Okay, and the fourth one, and daily recordings will be shared. And this is valid for 1 year. Anyway, next year new examples will come, don't worry. And this one, what else? Yeah, we also have a Telegram group. So why this Telegram group is, because suppose you have a question, suppose I just explain some project today and you understand that, yes, you understand it, and after going home you're trying to do that, you're getting some issue. Even though I shared the code, but still you want to do something new, because whatever you develop, same thing as I explained, doesn't matter, right? Anybody can use to do. But if you want to develop something new than my example, then you come across some errors. You search online, you search in Google, but somehow you can't able to figure out. Okay, so what you do? You should ask me. But when you're gonna meet me again in the next class, after exactly 24 hours, you're gonna ask me in the next meeting. You have to ask me the question, you have to share it, right? So I don't want any of my student to struggle like that. You have to get the immediate solution as soon as you get the problem. So that's the reason why I create a Telegram group. That's group name is UI Brains Online. This one. So why this group is, you just join the group. As soon as you get some issues or bugs here, you just take a screenshot and post it. And here all the people who are already joined the online, and the people who are currently joined this class also there in the group. Sometimes what happens, you know, one person get a doubt, and maybe in the group some other person knows the answer, right? So don't only just wait for me. You just post, just take a screenshot of the error and you post in the group. If the person who already knows, because there are many people are there in the group, the people who already know, they will reply so that we can share the knowledge. That's called as a teamwork, because in the company, that's the teamwork. It plays a major role. So who all knows the answer, they'll reply. If no one reply, I will reply. Okay, one more question you asked, sir. If you also don't know, don't worry. If I don't know, I know how to search in Google. I search in Google and I'll give you the respected links to go further. Okay, so don't worry, that much guarantee I can give you, because if I don't know, I search in Google and reply. Okay, I'll share the documentation which is there online, because ultimately we have to search in Google, because we learn the same way. Okay, that much help can be done, and it is available for 24/7. Okay, it saves a lot of time. Okay, that one. So hands-on experience, you're gonna learn, and notes will be shared, the PDF file. And the code will be shared on daily basis. And in that code, how it is developed, recording also there. So whenever you have a free time or you miss any video, by the time you are busy or something, you can just get this and you can just watch it for the whole 1 year. And we have a group. Even you may ask, sir, is there group for only for this 2 months or even the next period also? Don't worry. This group, until unless how many number of days you are satisfied with this group services, you can just be there. If you don't like this services, you can simply exit from the group. So until unless you exit from the group, you will be there in the group. Even after completion of the course, you join the company also, you get some issues in the company, you get some tasks also, you can share with the people, because so that the people who are there in the group are learners. So by seeing your tasks, they learn. Next time they get the same type of task in the company, they can do it. So that's the plan of, you know, the network of all the UI developers. That's the plan. Okay. And anything else? I think that's it. Okay, fine.
What's the Telegram group? I cannot download the app in my iPhone.
Oh, is it?
Not supporting it.
Telegram, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Actually, we can create a WhatsApp group, but some problems will come with WhatsApp group, because WhatsApp group numbers will be shared, because numbers, mobile numbers are
visible. More of security problems with WhatsApp.
Yeah, that's the security problem. Because even women's also there here, so I don't want, because I have already done for offline class, because a lot of problems I face, so I came for Telegram. I just see that for iPhone, why not working? Because we have not developed the application, right? So I just see some other solution for that, okay? I'll just reply you back. And sure. That's the course highlights. And also one last thing, some people is there in the mind of the people, but I know they're hesitant to ask. Okay, why should I trust? Sorry, not why. How should I trust you? Yes, that's the important question. Okay. And some people will feel like, sir, if I pay the fee and after some time you may shut down the class, that will never ever going to happen, because that's, I have a huge plan, and it's not like a simple only online class. I have a lot of other sources, you can just track it. I just tell you, see here, if you just simply go to Google, if you want to know about me, just simply go to Google and just type my name. This is my full name. You just type it. People are searching with my name. Lot of other this thing, GitHub, offline classes, YouTube. This is my old previous company. Yeah. So this is my GitHub profile. Okay, this is my GitHub profile, and I have some 13 repositories and 1.6k followers. So this getting this much followers is not that easy. It's not just 1 or 2 days. Okay, it just requires a lot of efforts and too much time you have to wait for. Okay, and even the best thing here is I'm just sharing the source code also here. It just started template. I mean, what is the course content we're gonna share in the courses? Yeah, all the files are shared here, but not complete code, just starter file. We have to make the complete file. Okay, only structure will be there. So just to note what applications I'm gonna teach. So complete each and every file number. So why I made each and every file number online here is because there is no skipping of the concept. I don't want to skip any concept. If I give you the file number like this, if I don't give the file number like this, you may think like whatever I teach, that is only core subject. No. If I give you the file number like this, if I miss any one file, you can just ask me, sir, you missed the one file. So like that, we don't want to skip any of a single concept. That's my plan. Okay, so that's why I giving all the course content online here. You can just watch each and every course, what files you're going to discuss. That's my GitHub account. And also I have a YouTube channel, UiBrains. Yeah, this is my YouTube channel, some 7-10 subscribers recently started. Okay, so here I explain, I also start doing some videos on UI here. And some coding. If you are not good at coding, you can just watch my coding videos here, because coding is very important, and that's even helps you in JavaScript and Node.js. So you can just start with the coding here. And I also started some UI recently. This is my YouTube channel, and this is my GitHub account, and also this is my website. This is just temporary website on GitHub. I'm going to launch the github.com. I just purchased the domain. I have to launch. I'm just still doing it. Okay, this is my website. Okay, and I also have a Facebook. This is my Facebook account. Yeah. So this is my Facebook account. Okay, and I also have a Facebook group called UI Brains. I think it is there. Yeah, this is my UI Brains group. Okay, so these many online sources you have, so you can trust me, don't worry. Okay.
I can fully trust you, sir, because I have watched your YouTube videos on Nourish IT and HTML.
Okay.
And I can say one more thing, sir.
Yeah.
I personally know you, so I totally trust you.
Yeah. We met in Hyderabad, right? Yes.
Yes. Recently, I visited India, so
yes.
It doesn't matter to me.
Yes. Okay, so that's it, guys. That's about, and even you can even just search about, if you don't know me, You can just online, just go to Google and search about me and just think about it and just watch this video once again and what application we're going to develop. Because I went a bit faster because in 2 hours we can't cover all this. So I just went a bit faster, I know. Don't worry, from tomorrow onwards we'll go a bit slowly. And tomorrow we understand what is software industry, how projects will come to the software company, and what is our role here. Because we should know the first what is our role. And after that, how to do a setup in your laptop and what are the required softwares we're going to do. I'm going to using WebStorm. You can use Visual Studio Code or Sublime Text or a lot of other editors are there, like Brackets, Atom, Dreamweaver. You can use any of them. So I just do a installation, and then we're going to start with a basic language called HTML. Okay, so that's the course plan. Okay, and that's it. Thank you so much. And any questions?
Yeah, how to make payment? Any link or
you have payment? I'm going to share you the mail. I'll just send you a mail again with my bank details. Actually, my plan is first 1 week is free, anybody can join. And after that week, I'll ask for the payment. And once the people who have done the payment, and for them, I'm going to give you the new link, because this link is going to be outdated. New link for the people who are already paid. Okay, so first 1 week, even I think middle of HTML also, it is free. So first 1 week is free for everybody. And after that, I'll send you a mail regarding the bank details and all. You can just page. And after that, the who are all paid for them, they can continue the next session.
Perfect.
Yeah. Any questions?
So Mike, like if somebody is not interested on like full stack, even you will cover a lot in HTML, CSS, Bootstrap or the client side. So we can apply in a job, right? With like the front end developer also, right? We will cover in more detail here, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So sir, after the completion of this course, will we be able to make our own full website? I mean,
Sure. Because we have not developed a simple application, because we developed a complete. Every technology we have a website, an example, right? Simple, man. If you want to make your own website, and even I forgot, we can even do the deployment online. How can we deploy the website online with a complete full face client, server, and database? Simple. Whatever all the concept we covered for jQuery, Ajax, Angular, the React, and everything, you just club all together. You make and keep in a one website with all the plugins and form validation. That's a perfect website. And I'll give you the assurance and guarantee that yes, you can develop your own website and even the next level. Because once we complete the HTML, because I can say what is the concept we learn in the course is not that is only the HTML, because next level is there, because every language, every technology is something next level we have to go. So I'll tell you some of the resources and the website which you can follow after HTML. And also in the lastly, I tell you how can you do the certification on UI also. There's something called Free Code Camp. So you can just start the development of this. Okay, so the complete, whatever the knowledge I have, I just share you, and you will be the perfect job ready for UI developer. Because a lot of people already got a job. So you can just search in my Facebook channel, Facebook page. I just used to post the people who got a job. Okay.
If we want to make resume already.
I have some resumes. We'll plan one day. The last day we can just plan how to prepare a resume. I also have some resumes, experience resume I share with. And that day, if you have any questions, you can ask me.
Sir, like I have some 8 year experience in Java and I want to do freelancing. Website development. So for that I want to join the course. So will it be helpful for me?
Yeah, seriously, it will be very helpful for you, because you can just learn the complete front end and back end and server side, right? Yes, you can develop any of the websites with a complete full-fledged as per the customer needs. Yes, it will be very helpful for you.
Naveen, is there any mobile applications you have developed with this technology?
Mobile applications we can't develop, but thing is we can develop a website which is responsive for mobile.
Okay.
It means the Bootstrap, that's called responsiveness. You can even see the view on mobile and tablet and even a laptop, because for mobile app there is a small limitation, because you have to install the app to see the features, right? But for website, mm-hmm. there are some crores of websites online, but crores of application you can't install. But if your website works perfectly, looks like a mobile app, you can just open a browser and you can just see all the websites in your mobile. So that's the advantage of websites. So even though every company having a mobile app, but still they maintain a website. Okay. But in this class, we are not developing any mobile app because that's required Android and React Native and Ionic and a lot of other things. Don't worry, I'm going to teach. Actually, I'm planning for this mobile apps in my YouTube channel. That's again a long story. But mobile apps, we are not discussing, only websites. Any questions?
Someone is shorting us.
Chatting, huh? Oh, sorry. What about newcomers? Newcomers. Okay. Newcomers, don't worry. I'm going to start from very scratch. Okay, I told you, right? First 1 week is free. Okay. In the first 1 week, we start with the HTML and we start developing of HTML things. So if you feel comfortable, you feel like, yes, I'm getting something, you can continue. Okay. If you feel like, no, it's very hard for me and I can't able to continue or something, then you can just reply back to me and tell you what you can do. Okay. Because you're paying for the course because you should get the 100% of the subjects. That's the only customer satisfaction I want. So just see for 1 week. If you are comfortable here, you can continue. Then you can choose any other. That's what I plan, right? Okay. Because I can say, frankly, because my subject, I can teach you from the very scratch level, because very basic level I can teach. You can just see for
Naveen, you have the tag from zero to hero.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, zero to hero, we can do it.
And I don't think for the newcomer, it will be a problem too, because we are not learning any like complex programming here, right? Or we start from HTML, CSS. And then
basics to, I can say yes, complex examples are there because what applications I showed you, maybe UI looks very simple, but you know, behind a lot of code is required. But don't worry, I'll just slowly make you, because actually what happens, you know, for every previous UI development classes I have attended, they just tell you all the concept, like HTML will cover everything, CSS they cover everything, and finally they're clubbing all the things and they develop a website. No, we are not doing like that. We are just developing what? Only HTML, some projects. Only CSS, some projects. Only JavaScript, like that. And by clubbing all the things like this, simple man. One person want to go for Olympic for running race. So first he has to start with the street level and then go for the next level and then India, the state level, like a country level, and then go for Olympics, right? That's same way we are learning. So you will be habituated the level of complexity also here.
Okay, so the more knowledge you provide, that will be great for us, you know.
thank you so much. Any questions? Okay, fine, thank you. 6:30 already. Oh, 1:04. So thank you so much once again for joining this course. I hope you will get the 100% subject here, and whatever the knowledge I have and what are the questions you have, I'll just clarify them in the course. And even after the course also, you can join the group and you can just ask some questions about it. And if you have any friends looking for the same course, you can just refer them. Okay. So thank you so much for joining, and we're going to start our first session from tomorrow. Okay.
Tomorrow is 5:00, right, sir?
Yeah, sure. Tomorrow 5:00 sharp. Because today first day, no? So many people have joined a bit late. So tomorrow we join exactly 5:00. So please be on
Saturday,
time.
Saturday, okay. Same time.
Actually you're in US, right?
Yeah.
Okay. For us, actually Sunday is a holiday. I mean, Indian time, 3rd November is a holiday. So tomorrow first session and Sunday is a holiday. So Sunday 3rd means for you, it is what? For you is next day, right? Monday.
For me, today is Thursday, 31st October.
Achha, okay. Then for you, Saturday is a holiday.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So
you, the time will be around, okay, 12 hours different.
Yes, 12 and something.
Yeah, 6 evening.
Yeah. So for US guys, Saturday is a holiday. And Indian guys, Sunday is a holiday. I just mentioned the IST, date and time, so you can just convert to your region, because some people are from Nigeria and all, but I don't know exactly Nigerian time. Okay, so that's you can take, but Indian time, Sunday is a holiday. every Sunday, like 3rd or 10th to 17 and 24 is a holiday. Okay.
And thank you.
Yeah. So that's it. Thank you so much for joining, and we're going to meet tomorrow. Right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.